Hey Team Ambition, Chanel Shea Peterson here, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing a video all about the little ritual, goddess bath, goal, intention, manifestation ritual that I did yesterday. And I just wanted to share it with you guys. Before we go too far deep into things, don't forget to give this video a like if you like it. Leave me a comment down below telling me what you'd like to see next. I create videos all about the energy and action required to achieve your biggest dreams, and I'd love to see what you want to see next. And of course, subscribe to Team Ambition. This is the place on the internet where we achieve our biggest dreams, and I'd love to have you a part of it. All right. So yesterday I wanted to do something kind of like a witchy, woo-woo, spirituality-based, specifically something that would help me, you know, give myself some self-care, raise my vibration, and help me achieve my biggest goals. I don't usually do stuff like this. Like, I've done like regular baths before, like trying to raise my vibration. I've done meditation before, obviously, yoga, you know. And I'm very conscious of my intentions when I do actions throughout the day. I try to be mindful. But I think it would be cool to start doing some actual, like, rituals to, I don't know, call in good energy. I'll give you a little rundown about what I did yesterday, and maybe that will inspire you to, like, try some of the things that I tried. Maybe you will give me some ideas in the comments as to how to get into, like, a deeper self-care intention setting practice. I don't know. It'll be great either way. The first thing that I did is I made myself a really nice, healthy dinner. I drank a big glass of water, and the salad that I made was like spinach and tofu and mushrooms. Then I did a goddess bath, and I'm not 100% sure if I did the whole goddess bath thing correctly. I'm sure there are no rules or anything. But basically, I just tried to set the space, you know, to be really high vibration. So for earth, I had my crystals set out. Water, obviously the tub provided lots of water. For fire, I lit some candles, and for air, I lit some incense. I used a Girl Power bath bomb by Lush because, you know, girl power, feminine energy, the moon, you know, I tried to like really captivate that energy. And literally, like, this bath was, I was so in love with it. I was having such a good time. It was so much fun. I did my normal shampoo, conditioner, face wash routine. After that normal routine that I would do every single day, I like kicked it up a notch, and I like used some of the products that I don't usually use. So I put a nice mask in my hair, put a face mask on, sat there, was really mindful of like the music that was playing and, you know, the warmth of the water. In that moment, I didn't meditate or anything, but like, I was just, it was obviously working because I was feeling really happy, really taken care of. And I think that's just kind of what the goal was in the first place. That was my intention. And then I did a body scrub. The body scrub was like my favorite part of the whole bath. Because my mom got me this stuff called like caviar, so it just sounds luxurious, right? While I was doing the body scrub, I was trying to think about all the reasons why I was really grateful for my body and my health. And I spent extra attention on my belly because I've been really mean to it lately. I've been really wanting abs and so sad I don't have abs, so gave that part a little extra love there. Then I shaved my legs, which is something that I don't normally do, and it really, like, felt luxurious. Like, after this bath, I felt like I had just walked out of, like, a spa. Then after all of that was said and done, I decided to do a chakra clearing meditation. And so the chakra clearing meditation I did, I just found it randomly on Spotify, and it was like, a meditation that I've done many times in the past. Basically, you go through each chakra, and I visualize like white light coming in through my head and like clearing the chakra. And then it was on to phase two of the whole thing. So I downloaded an app that told me what phase of the moon is in right now. And so yesterday the moon was in a waxing crescent moon phase, which I learned on the internet was the perfect time to, you know, do some goal setting. So I thought that I would take this round two time to like set my goals. If you've seen my how to up level your life video, highly recommended, check out the little eye in the top of the screen. You would know that I am working on three main goals until September 9th, my 25th birthday. Number one, I want to have money coming in from my cliche ambition yoga and YouTube channel. Number two, I want to like get some really nice abs and become like a yoga goddess, just like do yoga all the time. And then lastly, I just want to be more mindful, I guess more stable, less reactive, and just more at peace with the present moment. So I took this time to like really anchor myself in those goals even more than I had already been anchored in there. So I drank myself what I call like an ego elixir. Are you ready for this? I came up with this completely randomly. So this is just normal water that I put lemons and strawberries in. So this is like working on your lower triangle, your first three chakras. You know, your first chakra, that root chakra is red, is indicated by the strawberries. The second chakra is that sacral chakra, indicate like the water represents that sacral chakra. And then the solar plexus is the lemon. So when you drink this, like you are purifying that ego, you're purifying that lower triangle. So ego elixir water, like, and it's yummy. I don't even like lemon water, but like lemon strawberry water is amazing. So yeah, that's going to be a new staple for any ritual for my entire life now. I also like ate some like nice little sweet. This cake is actually from a birthday party that was happening in my house that night. So I was just, you know, giving myself some love by eating myself a nice little piece of cake there. So after drinking my ego elixir and after eating the cake, I did do like a 20-minute meditation, and then I did a reading. And so the only oracle cards, the only cards I have are these Angels of Abundance cards, and I really like them. And the reading that I did was extremely, extremely accurate. So I asked the Angels of Abundance, you know, what can I do this week to, you know, have the most abundance in my week? First thing they said was to focus on your priorities, which, yes, just keep doing what I'm doing. Then dreams of abundance. The angels were telling me that in my dreams they were giving me, like, signals and signs. I am so appreciative of that, angels. Thank you for coming to me in my dreams, because I would love to talk to you more, and I'm sure that I cut off that communication quite often. And then lastly, the card that I get every single time I do a reading, I swear to you guys, no more complaining. Thank you, angels, for this amazing reading, and I did thank them. I was very happy with that reading. So after I did that reading, I did some light journaling, nothing too crazy, just like what I did that day. And I ended with some like goal setting, since it was, like I said, the waxing moon. I already actually have a schedule for what I want to accomplish for like my yoga and my, you know, being more grounded goals. But what I don't have is like a clear-cut plan for my abs. So I did sit down and I tried to make a plan. It wasn't really going anywhere. I wasn't 100% happy with what my plan was, but I like decided it was ready for bed. I like, you know, rolled up my mat, I put my candles away, all that, went to bed, and then this morning I was just like scrolling on YouTube and I noticed that one of my favorite YouTubers actually used Center, which is the Chris Hemsworth app that's new, for 30 days, and he got like incredible results with his abs. So I'm gonna try that 7-day free trial. Thank you, moon energy and the universe, for like answering my prayers. But yeah, I like that I felt supported last night. like waking up and having an answer to something that I wasn't 100% happy with yesterday. The plan that I had set wasn't 100% something I was happy with, so like, thank you. Thank you, universe. That was really cool. Yeah, so that was my goddess bath new moon ritual that I tried out. Tell me what you guys do for rituals, what you're taking from what I did. Highly recommend trying the ego elixir. Yeah, and with that, all my love is yours. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys.